Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's video, I'm going to give you 5 tips in Microsoft Excel when using Sparklines. Let's dive in right now. In case you're wondering what the heck is a Sparkline is a miniature chart. So here's my example. I've got these products listed with 6 months. If I wanted to do product one, I could highlight this, insert tab, and throw in a chart. Well, there's product one, but then I got to go do product 2, 3, and 4. I want to quickly make miniature charts of every one of these products. This could be products. This could be locations. It could be actual employees, financial data for different years, whatever you want it to be. So I'm going to highlight the range, or I'm going to put the Sparklines first. Insert tab. I even have a Sparklines group. Column and line would work here. I'm going to go with column. You can always swap it if you don't like it. It wants to know what my data range is. We highlight the right range. I highlighted cell B2 to G16, and I've already highlighted the location range. Click OK, and here comes my Sparklines. Those are miniature charts. So tip number one for Sparklines is you can set up the high and low points. Sparkline tab is available. It is a contextual tab. So if you click out of here, you don't see Sparklines. Click back in here, Sparkline tab. Marker, the high point, I'm going to put in green. You pick whatever colors you want to. And I'm going to come back in here and do a low point and put in a red font color. There is your high and low points. That is tip number one. Tip number two, and I get this question all the time, is someone says, Chris, I want to get rid of these Sparklines. What do I do? It is still the Sparkline tab. Notice you got a group and over here is clear. So this is tip 2 and 3. If you want to clear the entire item, it's clear selected Sparklines group. Bye-bye. Control Z is undo. We bring that back. What if you want to clear just one? This product 5, I don't want to see. Sparkline clear, and that will clear just that one right there. That is exactly the same when you click on clear is clear selected Sparklines, which is the default. So there's your 2 clears. Again, I'm going to undo and bring that back. Tip number 4, not the best example, but I'll do this anyway. A lot of times in data, especially financial data, notice in column B, instead of saying January, assume that that's the current year. And then cell C1 is the previous year. D1 is 2 years ago. So I may want to see the current year here, but I want to see the Sparklines in a reverse order. So if you highlight your Sparklines, Sparkline tab, and it's over here, you can plot data right to left. Again, not the best example here, but I see this a lot with financial data when the most current year is over in column B and the last year is over in column G. Let me turn that back around though and do that one. Another tip, I believe this is tip number 5, and this is probably one of my favorites. I'm going to click out of here, and also, I'm not including this in my tips, but make sure you give yourself some row height in here when you're doing Sparklines. Here's my issue. If you look at row 2, the high number is 125. Now go look at row 10, which is product 9. Well, the high number there is that 58. Actually, I'm going to change it to 60 just to have a unique number. There you go. Well, the columns look the same in row 2 and in row 10. So here I am again back in my Sparklines. I do this all the time. Come over to axis. I've got a vertical axis for the minimum and for the maximum. Automatic is set for each. Go ahead and make it same for all Sparklines. So before I do this, look at row 2 and then also look at row 10 real quick. And here we go. Same for all. Same for all. So now it's, to me, that's a little bit easier to read and realize that product 1, that 125, is a lot greater than product 9 being 60. Like, that's up to you though, but that's something I usually do with my sparklines. Another bonus tip for you, if you don't like columns, you could either go with win or loss or line. Win or loss here isn't going to do any good, but line may work for you. So there you go with sparklines. Miniature charts, great feature. You should know how to use sparklines in Excel. Feel free to subscribe. I really appreciate your time. We recently went over 40,000 subscribers. I can't tell you how much I appreciate that. Have a great day. Thank you.